Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Brecksville United Methodist Church and our online worship this morning. I am Pastor Heidi Welch, and whether you call Brecksville UMC your spiritual home or this is your first time with us, we are glad that we are able to worship together this morning. As you tune in, I invite you to say hello in the comments and let us know who is joining this morning. We are in the sanctuary. This is going to be our permanent home. Right now, I am looking at a little camera that's right below the balcony. If you've ever been in our sanctuary, you know where that is. It's right below the TV. On the TV, there's a beautiful picture of us, our family picture from the fall kickoff last year. And this is going to be our new setup. We have our camera installed, so we will be able to continue to live stream our worship services and connect with people all over the country and all over the world if we want to. After we come back physically together, we will continue to be able to worship together online as well. Brecksville UMC strives to be an inclusive church, which means that we intentionally make space for everyone to encounter a loving God, no matter your age, your gender, your income level, your race, your sexual orientation, or your ability. You are welcome here, and we want to serve with you and alongside you. We don't have our red welcome folders this morning, but I invite you to use the comment section for that. And then there is also an attendance form that you can fill out to tell us a little bit about yourself. You're invited to use that as well. It's good to use the comment section, use the hearts and the likes on Facebook to let us know how you're enjoying things this morning. You can give us a shout out with the little, like, surprised, I don't know, what is it? Surprise emoji thing? We'll call it that. There will be a time during the service where you can use the comment section for prayer. So if you have any prayers that you would like for us to be praying with you or for you, you will be able to send those in, and we will see them and we will be praying with you for that. It really is. It's good to be worshiping together this morning on this beautiful, beautiful day, even if we can't physically be with one another. We are gathered in spirit, we are united in Christ, and that is what is most important. This morning we have our skeleton crew joining us. We have Jamie, our praise band leader, who is singing. Malik, our music director, is on piano. And Russ Welch, my husband, is faithfully on guitar. Jenny, our Christian education person, will bring a children's moment a little bit later for the kids. And now we have Melanie, social distancing, up in the balcony, and she is running our live stream equipment. Be patient with us. This is our first time, and grace is greatly appreciated. Our desire this morning, more than anything, is that this worship time together is refreshing and encouraging to you and pleasing and joyful to God. So let us begin our time together with prayer, and let us do our 6:50 prayer. This is a prayer that you are invited to pray at 6:50 in the morning or the evening, whatever works best for you. And this is something that can unite us. We can unite our voices in prayer no matter where we are in the world. It's on our Facebook page each day. If you don't have a physical card, that's just fine. You can find the information there, and it's also on our website. So let us pray together. Transcendent God, we are separated by physical distance, yet we realize that no matter where we are connected by your Holy Spirit and your boundless love. Lord of us all, you know the anxieties in our hearts and minds. We pray that we might find solace and connection, relief from a chaotic world, and remember that you, God, are the firm foundation on which we stand. Amen. Now, as the guys sing a few songs, I invite you to get the kids ready. After this, we will have our children's moment with Jenny Gee.
God of creation, there at the start, before the beginning of time. With no point of reference, you spoke to the dark and fleshed out the wonder of light. And as you speak, 100 billion galaxies are born. In the vapor of your breath, the planets form. The stars were made to worship so light. I can see your heart in everything you've made. Every burning star, a signal fire of grace. Creation sings your praises so light. God of your promise, don't speak in vain, no syllable empty or void. For once you have spoken, all nature and science follow the sound of your voice. And as you speak, 100 billion creatures catch your breath, evolving in pursuit of what you said. If it all reveals your nature so alive, I can see your heart in everything you say. Every painted sky, a canvas of your grace. Creation still obeys you so alive, so alive. If the stars were made to worship so alive, if the mountains bow in reverence so alive, oceans roar your greatness so alive. For if everything exists to lift you high, so alive. The wind goes where you send it, so alive. If the rocks cry out in silence, so alive. If the sum of all our praises still fall shy, we'll sing again 100 billion times. God of salvation, you chased down my heart through all of my failure and pride. On a hill you created a light of the world, abandoned in darkness to die. And as you speak, 100 billion failures disappear. Well, you lost your life so I could find it here. If you left the grave behind you, so alive. I can see your heart in everything you've done. Every part designed in a work of art called love. If you gladly chose surrender, so alive. I can see your heart 8 billion different ways. Every precious one, a child you died to save. If you gave your life to love them, so will I. But what measure could amount to your desire? You're the one who never leaves the one behind.
Welcome, everyone. I invite you to sing along as you have the lyrics in front of you. As I said last week, sing along as loud as you can. We can't judge you, your family might, but that's what the rest of the week's about.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go in every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go of me. I can see the light that is coming for the heart. Troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you here on the earth. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I? And shall I be? Oh no, you never let go through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go in every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go of me. Yes, I can see a light that is coming for the heart that holds on, and there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will
even
praise you.
You don't have to leave your house, it's still the Sunday after Easter low attendance.
Yes, I can see a light that is coming for the heart that holds on, and there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will praise you. Oh no, you never let go through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go in every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go. Through the storm, oh no, you never let go in every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go of me.
And Owen and Addie and Austin and Ella and Eddie, and anybody else who I'm missing, I'm sorry I'm missing you. I just saw some of your names come across saying that you're watching, and so I'm excited. And I want to talk to you guys because you know about this, but I want to bring everybody else in on it. You know, each week when we're meeting here together, after children's moment, we go downstairs to Sprouts. And during Sprouts, we watch our little short video, and we watch the people who are not colored in. And I always ask you what that means. And you tell me that what that means is, even though God is right there with them, they forget. And so I want to talk to us a little bit more about that today. I want to talk to you a little bit about what it is like in life when we just forget.
So it's the week after Easter, and I could still say to you, Happy Easter. I could tell you that Easter doesn't end after Easter Sunday. It goes on for another 50 days that we're going to be celebrating Jesus rising and Jesus being right here with us. But again, this is something that kids and grown-ups and everybody forgets sometimes. And sometimes we forget when life is kind of hard. And so I have here, I don't know if you can see this, but what I have is a plate. And I put on it some ketchup and some mustard and some syrup. And I want you to think of the ketchup as the tough times in your life, really hard things that you have to do. And I want you to think of the syrup as the sweet, wonderful, great times. And I want you to think of the mustard as maybe the sad times, the times when you're feeling blue and you're feeling low. And then I want you to think about this, and think about this during the week. We all are walking around in the world like a little sponge. We can take all kinds of things in. We can look at something that's really beautiful. We can sit with someone who's really sad, and that's good. And when we do it, and we do it all by ourselves without God, we're kind of like this. So see, we don't do much. You see that? We just kind of make a mess sometimes, and sometimes we just don't get the full joy. You know, we don't get that full sweet syrup that we could get, or we don't really get to sit and understand where someone's coming from when they're sad or when we're sad when we don't have Jesus. But Jesus called himself the living water, and so I'm gonna make this sponge filled with water. Got a little bucket down here that I'm putting it into. And now we're going to go back to all those things in our life, and we're going to take them with Jesus.
I got too much Jesus there. Look at the difference.
Look at how different it is when we can approach the world filled with Jesus, loaded up and understanding that everything, the good times, the bad times, the people who are there for us are gifts from God. And that when Jesus fills our heart and our soul, we just look at everything differently. So think about that this week. Easter was last week, but we don't forget about it. We remember, we keep Jesus in our heart, we keep Jesus in our soul, and we remember he's right here with us every step of the way. We are colored in. Let's pray. Lord, help us to celebrate this Easter season. Help us to just love you, see you, feel you in our hearts. Amen.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
We have a few ministry moments this morning. But first, if you want to receive some weekly updates from us about what's going on here at Brecksville UMC, you can message us on Facebook or you can email us at office@brecksvilleumc.com. And we have all kinds of ways that we are continuing to connect and grow and learn throughout the week with our kids, our teens, and our adults. And so if you connect with us, then we can let you know all of the happenings going on here and what we are doing to stay connected through the week. Next week, we have our blood drive with Vitalant, and right now is a very important time to be giving blood. They are in desperate need of blood right now, and so I invite you to come, and we will have a blood drive here at the church building next Sunday on the 26th, and it will be in the fellowship hall as a way to help social distance while giving blood, make sure there's more distance between people to give blood. And so you can find out more information. There's some links there to help you out in the comments. And then also we have our YSP flower basket sale that is going on. We are having that annual Mother's Day sale of the hanging flower baskets, and they will benefit YSP, our youth service project. But like everything this year, it is a little bit different, and so what you will do is you will go to the link that is found in the comments, or if you're on our website, it's on the side during the ministry moment section, and there's a link there so you can go online, you can order your flowers, and then you will be mailed or emailed a voucher, and then you just go to Coleman's greenhouse, you drive up, and they will put the flowers in your trunk or in your back seat, and maintaining social distance, but still able to get your flowers. And it's a way to support a local business, but most importantly, it's also a way to support our youth that are going on our YSP, our Youth Service Project, mission trip this year. And even if right now the mission trip is still on there, still going this June, but even if they don't go this summer, they will go next year, and they will have more opportunities to serve and to be the hands and feet of Jesus. And so it will, if it doesn't go to this year's trip, it will go to next year's trip. So be assured of that. And then also, I do want to give a shout out to the teens. Dana, is our youth director, is having a Zoom youth group tonight. And so if you haven't done so already, text her, let her know that you want to join in, and she will get you the information for that as well. It really is wonderful that even though we are physically distant from one another, we can't be together physically, we still have many ministries and many mission opportunities going on here at Brecksville UMC. Our ministry and our missions still continue, and we still continue to be the church, a group of people who are focused on loving God, growing in that love, and showing that love to others. So at this time, I invite you to take a moment and prepare your offering. Whether you give online or by text or by mail, or by mailing it into the church, take a moment right now, because giving is a practical way that you can say, yes, I believe in the mission and the ministry of this church. So let us give thanks to God by giving our tithes and our offerings.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord, we offer to you today a token of our lives and our substance. Take our lives and take these gifts. May they be instruments of your peace and your joy, bringing healing and reconciliation for all your people to you. Amen. This morning's scripture reading is from the New Testament, the section of the Bible that tells us about Jesus' life and ministry and death and resurrection, and also about the early church and letters to the early Christians. We will be reading this morning from 1 Peter, which is a letter that was written to encourage Christians who were in exile. And you can read from any version of the Bible. The words may be a little different, but the theme, the message is still the same. Hear what the author says to these Christians, beginning in verse 3 of chapter 1. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because of his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you. You are being guarded by God's power through faith for a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the last time. You rejoice in this, even though now, for a short time, if necessary, you suffer grief in various trials, so that the proven character of your faith, more valuable than gold, which though perishable is refined by fire, may it result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though not seeing him now, you believe in him. And you rejoice with an inexpressible and glorious joy because you are receiving the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his word. Now, when you think of joy, what image or thought comes to mind? For me, it's the song Joy to the World that we often sing at the end of our Christmas Eve services every year. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let heaven and nature sing. I have a very clear memory of when I was in 9th or 10th grade, and we sang this song at the end of the Christmas Eve service. And I don't know what came over me in that moment, but I sang the first notes of the song in what I think was a beautiful soprano voice, but what I know was very loudly. I know it was very loudly because the people in front of me turned around in surprise to look at me. And my dad, who was standing next to me, elbowed me and started laughing and looking at me like, where did this voice come from? I didn't know where the notes came from, but I knew that it was an expression of the joy that I was feeling in that moment. Joy because I was there in that beautiful sanctuary with my family, with my church family, and joy that our Savior was born and into this world, and our world then was filled with light and hope because of it. And that's the joy that we most often think about. Happiness that bubbles over because we know of the unconditional love of Jesus, or because we've been shown that love by someone else. When we think of joyful people, we think of those who always seem to be smiling and happy, and nothing in the world seems to be able to keep them down. And if that's the case, then joy is not something that most of us feel very often. In those special moments, yes, we feel that joy, but not on a day-to-day basis. What if, though, we thought of joy a little bit differently? What if joy is that extreme happiness that we feel, that elation that fills our entire body when we experience or are reminded of the greatness of God? But what if joy is also more contented, a joy that constantly fills our heart, no matter what is going on around us? contented, I am assured by Google, means happy and at ease. Contented joy, then, is a joy that you settle into, a joy that settles into you, no matter what is going on around you. First Peter was written to Christians who were in exile in Asia Minor. Christians who were exiles not because they physically had to move away from where they had once lived, but because they chose a different life. They were pagans who chose a new life with Jesus, and because of that, they were exiled from their old family and friends who were not Christians. They weren't necessarily being outwardly persecuted, but life wasn't easy for them. They were on the outside, yet surrounded by the life that they once lived. And it's to these people that the author of 1 Peter is speaking to, those people who are in exile in their own place. Beginning in verse 6 of our scripture today, it says, "You rejoice in this, even though now for a short time, if necessary, you suffer grief in various trials, so that the proven character of your faith, faith that's more valuable than gold, which though perishable, is refined by fire, that faith may result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Though you have not seen him," you have not seen Jesus, "you have him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with inexpressible and glorious joy. For you are receiving the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. In the midst of your discomfort and sadness and loneliness, he is saying, be joyful. Be joyful because you have been given a living hope and a new birth." We are also in an exile of sorts, an exile from our normal lives. Of course, this isn't the same as the exile that the author of 1 Peter was talking about, but it's an exile nonetheless. We find ourselves physically at home, but it's not a home that we are used to. It might be even more crowded than normal or louder than normal, containing your entire life, your work, your family, your restaurants, your recreational activities like Uno or puzzles or Battleship or Netflix. Or it might be eerily quiet and lonely, like one might imagine an isolation cell feeling like. We are in an exile, and yet we are still able to live in joy, a contented joy, because even though we aren't really at home, really in a place that we are used to and necessarily comfortable with, we are nonetheless blessed by God's mercy. A contented joy that feels like settling into a big and cozy chair. A joy that surrounds us and supports us and cushions us from the weight of life. A contented joy that is rooted in a hope that is constant, no matter our external circumstances. This hope is of new life in the resurrection. Like Jenny said, we are in an Easter season. We are called to remember the Easter proclamation, the Easter miracle of resurrection, and what that means to our lives. This new life is our gift. It's not based on our merits. It's not earned by the sweat of our brows, but it's earned by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. This hope is the gift of Easter, a gift that is ours, and a gift that nothing can diminish. Nothing can snatch it out of our grasp. Nothing can take it from us. It is ours, as sure as the air that we breathe, as sure as the light that we see, as sure as the hope in our hearts. It is ours to have. So I pray that this week you find space for that contented joy, in your heart and in your life. Now, this contented joy won't fix everything, but it will remind you to be grateful for what you have around you. It will remind you that Jesus has already saved us, so you don't have to. It will remind us that you don't need to do everything through your own power, but like Jenny said, we need to soak up the power, the hope, the joy of the resurrection. It's a gift that will remind us, this contented joy will remind us that we are loved no matter what. Thanks be to God. Let's pray. Most holy Lord, we pray that we might feel you and know of your joy that is living within us, your joy that is all around us, in small things and in the big things. God, we pray that we might feel this in our lives, that we might feel this each and every day until we are gathered again through your Spirit. We pray these things in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our next song, as Malik plays for us, you're invited to sing. You're also invited to write your prayer concerns in the comments. And if you are watching on our website and you're not able to write them in the comments, I invite you to take a moment before Sunday, and you can email your prayer concerns to the office email. You can email them directly to me, and we can make sure that we are praying for your prayers as well. So let us pray and prepare our hearts for prayer with song.
How firm a foundation, ye saints of the Lord, is laid for your faith in his excellent word. What more can he say than to you he has said, to you who for refuge to Jesus has fled? Fear not, I am with you, but be not dismayed, for I am thy God, and will still be the aid. I'll strengthen and help thee, and cause thee to stand upheld by my righteous omnipotent hand. When through the deep waters I call ye to go, the rivers of woe, and to that giver flow, for I will not be with thee, troubles bless, thy dross to consume, and thy gold to refine. The soul that on Jesus still leans for repose, I will not desert you its foes. That soul, though all hell does endeavor to shake, I'll never forsake.
We have a few prayer concerns that have come through Facebook already. Prayers for Barry and family as his father died this past week. That one's from Amy. And Sarah asked for prayers for safety to all through this pandemic. And then also prayers for all of those who are struggling during this time. I just want to say, as we see the prayers coming in, that I am grateful to be able to see so many wonderful faces on Facebook, to see all of the different people that are joining us from near and far. The magic of technology really is nice, especially when it works. Dana asked for prayers for young people who had to mourn canceled events and uncertain plans moving forward. And Anne asked for prayers for the youth and summer mission trip. It is good that we are able to come together in prayer in this way, and we are able to support one another even though we are far away from one another. Penelope asked for prayers for homeless and hungry. Facebook's telling me I reached my limit for today and I have to ignore it. Deborah says joy for the birth of our granddaughter, Julie Aaron, who's born on Monday, and to Beth and Aaron. And I know that Debbie is down there caring for them, and she is very excited to do that. Kim asked for prayers for the elderly who may be lonely right now. Yes, definitely. If you continue to send in your prayer concerns, even if we don't name them right now, know that we will be praying with them, for them, and we will add them to our prayer concern list. So let us go to our Lord in prayer. Amazing and wonderful God, we come this morning just a week after Easter, but it feels much longer in many ways. Easter and its celebration have slid so quickly into the past, and we again are tempted to move back into our doubts and our fears. But we pray that you might fill us with the joy of new life again. Remind us that the signs of Jesus' resurrection are all around us, in the sun, in the flowers, in the ways that we see new life birthing around us in nature. God, you have heard the names and the situations of all those things that are going on this morning, those things that we have lifted up to you in name. And Lord, we know there are many things that are still on our hearts. As we remember our friends and our family who suffer from illness and loss, we pray that you might help us to be a presence of comfort for them. For those who are lost and alone, we ask that you empower us to reach out and compassion and offering to help, a help that will lift them into a new life with you. Lord, we pray for those who feel isolated from family and friends right now. We pray that you might bring comfort and assurance that they have not been forgotten. And Lord, we pray for our government leaders. We ask for wisdom and discernment for them and a heart that is bent toward you. Give us confidence, Lord, that even when we don't have the words to pray, your Spirit intercedes for us. And we pause now to lift up to you our silent prayers that lay heavy on our hearts. And let us not forget the blessings, Lord, that are easily at our fingertips. Clean water, electricity, food in our pantry, and fresh air to breathe. And thank you, Lord, for doctors and nurses, hospital staff and nursing home caregivers, EMTs and pharmacists, teachers and counselors, and all those who love our children from afar. You, Lord, have given us blessings in these people. In this time and always, we ask that you give us compassion for one another, patience, and strength. Help us to see the amazing things that we haven't even imagined yet, amazing things that are right in our midst. We ask these things in Jesus' name as we pray the prayer that he taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. I thank you for joining us this morning from wherever you are, and I invite you to grab another cup of coffee or your first cup of coffee and join us for our Zoom coffee hour. The information will be in a link for you, and it is great to be worshiping together. I miss you, I love you, but as we go from this time together, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace. Go in peace and not in pieces. I'll see you soon.